Hello and welcome to Blair Park here in Hurlford. It's a big match today. It's a Killer Legends match. You can just see the guys at the back there start to warm up. With me again, we've got George Watt, Andrew Ferguson. I'm going to go to George. Firstly, George.
Fantastic day, Eddie. A great reason to be here, Ayrshire Cancer Support. Been fair looking around. A lot of the guys have taken out of time. They've all turned up. Both managers have got a kind of full complement of the squad.
Excellent to see some old faces showing up. You know, helping out, supporting the charity, it's what it's all about, isn't it?
Andrew, two managers, it's Monty's Marvels teams, Ray Montgomery, Jim Clayton, trying to work out their team. Just trying to work out who's turned up, who's not turned up, what formation he's going. There is one legend.
A true legend of the game.
Andrew, can I tell you, this man scored 55 goals one year in a season for Nottingham Fever.
Aye.
The Marvel. We're just walking around the crowd at the moment of the charity, the cancer charity today. We've came to the Tesco, proud to support the local community store. How's your goodie bags going? Are still there?
Goodie bags to every kid in the place, yep.
Can't quite remember their names right enough. Today we've got Alan Kerr, one of the Kamarnock legends, as indeed a Kamarnock legend, was in the Kamarnock squad that lifted the cup in 1987. Andrew, we've got Colin Rusty Hartness with us on one of the Rookies Heroes teams. Colin is still playing football with myself at the just over 50s as opposed to the well over 35s. Okay Andrew, we've got another two Kilmarnock legends here, Al Mahood, Milo Giaconelli, two fantastic players. Alan's still playing football at over 35. Milo just had to pack it in because he got married. So Milo, tell me a bit about your time at Kilmarnock.
I went to Kilmarnock straight for school, so I went in there as a YTS. Spent a couple of years cleaning the likes of hoodies, Durante's boots and all that, learning my trade under Williamson.
Alan, yourself, you were at Kilmarnock for a few years, a number of games under your belt, yeah?
I was there for 6 years all in, about 150, 160 games.
And what are you doing just now with the football?
I'm back in at Kilmarnock as a head of recruitment for the academy.
Okay, Andrew, with David Syme, one of the current stars in the red team.
Kilmarnock time was great.
Good.
Probably my last year, and I fractured my leg towards the end, isn't it? Pretty good. Yeah. But other than that, I've thoroughly enjoyed my time. I was here since I was under 10s.
Good,
yeah. And I was your captain all the way to 17s and then got my first team kind of start at 17. So after that, I've done okay.
So, big event, big charity event, looking forward to it?
Yes, very much so. Very much so. It's not often you see so many famous faces be down the years and you get a chance to referee them. Some of them being your own heroes as well back in the day. So it'll be quite interesting just to see how it goes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the teams this afternoon. It's Rookies Heroes! Make as much noise as you can! Legends including Andy McLaren, Gordon Smith, Gary Hay. Welcome back to the studio. Craig Dargold there as well. Remember the song D-A-R-G-O? Led out by Captain Ray Montgomery. It's Monty's Alan Brown, the MP there as well. Chris Kyle behind him for Kilmarnock Football Club. Alan Mahood is there! The man that last put Kelly in Europe as well in 2011 with that goal. The cross from the Giacomo, the top up from Mahood. Mark Roberts is here as well. And Spearsy, the goalkeeper, amongst others. And ladies and gentlemen, a boo for the officials! Boo!
And it's Monty's Heroes in the blue to get the very first Killer Legends charity match underway here in aid of Ayrshire Cancer Support. as Hookie's heroes nick the ball. Oh, there's a crunching tackle by Montgomery. And we're just 5 minutes into the game and already Monty's heroes are showing signs of fatigue. And it's 5 out of 10 for approach, takeoff and execution for that dive. And here goes Jinky Hollywood. And he slams it low into the net for Hookie's heroes. 1-0.
I don't know whether that one was straight from the training ground there, Andrew, but he stumbled, fell, headed up the line and kept the ball in. So the ball broke away. Good finish for the young guy. I think looking at the teams at the moment, Andrew, the Reds have youth on their side.
Yes, George, it looks like a case of your head's willing, but your legs can't catch up.
It's a penalty!
And here comes Hookie's heroes again. It's a cross, and it's goal number 2 to Hookie's heroes.
Hookie's heroes, have just put on Andy McLaren. Great work up, great work in the middle of the park with Gary Hay, who's a Kilmarnock legend, 400-500 games with him. Great 1-2 with Craig Dargo, great finish. I thought he was going to miss it there. You see that, had a bobble at the end there, but great finish.
Beautiful.
And eventually Monty's team of marvels make it to the other end of the park, but it's a poor cross.
Oh, beautiful, Charlie! Beautiful!
And it's Adams to Matthews. The cross, oh, it's just too high for Kerr. It's another quick build-up by heroes. Goal, but it's offside.
We're going okay just now. It was an inspirational team talk for Gordon Smith. I was a wee bit perturbed when playing a back five in a charity game, but it seems to work wonders.
And once again, it's Andy McLaren showing his class with another razor sharp pass for goal number 3 to the heroes. Again, it's Mahood to Riley. He's onside. But again, the heroes keeper blocked another powerful shot. It's another great pass by McLaren. And it's goal number 4 for the heroes. And once again, you can see midfield maestro McLaren instrumental in laying off another great ball for the heroes' number 4 goal. And straight from the kickoff, the heroes are again on the attack. Across the 6-yard line, and Lachlan Hyatt from the Kilmarnock standard and Killy's number 1 fan slots the ball home.
Yeah, it's a wee bit getting a wee bit one-sided just now, Andrew, isn't it? I think the introduction of Andy McLaren, as we spoke about earlier on, it's been a huge difference to the game. That's
strolling it.
He scored one set up. I think that's the third one he set up just now. So there's certainly youth on the red team side, no doubt about that. But I'm just looking over at the bench and the Blues, there's probably still a wee bit of experience that come on there that might turn it around.
And it's 5-0 to the heroes, and could they take this to double figures before half-time? Oh, and Mahood just skims the post.
Oh, yeah. Oh!
Andrew, I'm with the Blues manager, Jim Fleeton. Jim, what
did you think about that half-time? Oh, there was no one in there. There was good people sitting about the place. It was good. It was good to get into the dressing room. But obviously, there's a scoreline there that most of them are thinking about. I'm not thinking about it. You know, they're here to pick up money for a very, very good cause. And, help us out with the case and get a few quid to beat this cancer.
What about the influence of Mr. McCartney come on?
Magical. It was absolutely magical.
Pivotal to
it was.
Success at the
Red. Correct. Magical it was. I think it's the youth more so than the talent. So that's probably the case. But so,
good. I see you keep the big guns for the extra time and penalties, isn't it?
Correct.
Is that
correct.
Nice?
That's what I'm going for.
Good luck with the extra half.
Cheers. Thank you.
Thank you.
And it's the Heroes to get us underway in the second half. Sime has a shot, and that would have been a spectacular opening goal to the second half. And it's the Marvels trying to break through the hooky defence. Here's a penalty to Monty's Marvels.
Thoughts on the start to the second half, Jared?
Much better start to the second half for the Blues, Andrew. They've got a penalty back there. Not sure whether it was a penalty. I know it was a great penalty, great finish, but over really great penalty by him.
You know what
play
the
job in,
don't you?
Oh, it's a bad mistake. And it's a great save by Wallace.
Take the line out then. Go on, take the line with that.
And once again, it's the pace of the Heroes. Too much for the Marvels. It's a pass. It's a jink. And it's a goal. Goal number 6 to the Heroes. And almost walking the ball into the back of the net. Oh, and Monty's defence is at 6s and 7s, and it's Wallace to rescue again.
No bother, I mean, if you pack up front all day, just chase
him. That's another great pass to Hollywood. Oh, and it smashes against the upright. It's a free kick to Monty's Marvels. And it's a quick one to Reid. Oh!
That's great.
Well, pick that one out. I've never seen that one coming straight to the training ground, obviously. Fantastic. I think the Blues deserve that with their performance this half. They've been terrific. Up against a bit of youth, I would imagine, in the Reds. But it did look as if he'd actually worked on it. The ball played inside, cut back to the boy now. Methadone Mick straight from Jack Victor, top corner. What a goal.
And it's a shot. Oh, a great save again by Wallace.
Give you 40 yards your start.
Don't dive in.
And it's a corner to Hooky's Heroes. Gary Hay. And it's a goal. And it's sneaked in between Wallace and Montgomery.
Come on in.
Goal number 7 to Hooky's Heroes. And time will be running out for Monty's Heroes. 5 goals you need to get to pull a draw. Sign breaks. And it's another goal to Hooky's Heroes by Sign. It's goal number 8. And can Monty's Marvels get 6 goals in the last 10 minutes or so of this game? Oh, and it's a terrific last ditch tackle. And it's a shot. Oh, and a great save again by Wallace. And on comes Zippy to add some zip to the Marvel front line. Oh, and it's a Heroes keeper performing a WWF body slam on Zippy for a penalty to Monty's Marvels.
And yourself, Zippy!
And there's nifty stuff from Rusty Harkness. Oh, and he just run out of steam. And there goes the final whistle here at Blair Park in Hurlford for the Ayrshire Cancer Support Killy Legends charity football match. And it's Hookie's Heroes winning 8-3 against Monty's Marvels.
Please, I'd like to welcome up director of Kilmarnock Football Club to present the prizes, Ms. Cathy Jamieson. But please welcome up your winners of the trophy this year, with some great legends in there as well. Ian Durant thinking he's funny. He's not. Pulling out a few green tickets there as well. But I thought they played really well. Let's hear it then. For Hookie's Heroes! We're up by Captain Gary Hay. Gary, I've got a quick word with you. Right, so our man of the match is then. John Galt, drum roll please.
The man of the match is Taylor
Hollywood. Oh, yeah. Congratulations, Taylor. Well done, mate. Get your trophy from John Gordon and being the victors. Well done. But ladies and gentlemen, let's hear that again, please. For both teams, all our legends, our volunteers, and our mascots. Well,
well, here I am with Josh Hollywood, who organised the whole event. Josh, are you happy with it?
Oh, delighted. Turnout today, I think we've hit over 500 people, so it's been a long time coming. First week in January, we started putting the plans in motion, and I'm delighted. I mean, 72 mascots in total today. So they've raised over £5,000 alone from the mascots. So a big thanks to everyone who's came. On to the dinner tonight. So yeah, it's a good day, first one ever it's been done, so we'll try and do it again next year and try and raise more.
You were just saying earlier on there's about £10,000 roughly you've sent so far.
Maybe more now, yeah. I'll get the numbers this week, but all the money goes to the charity, so it's been great. So it's been fantastic all round.
How's it feel being on the strip, being in there with your
It was good, I played for 5 minutes and I'm knackered, but, but apart from that, it's been good.
Are you ready for tonight then?
I am ready for tonight, so sold out Fenwick Hotel. So we'll try and raise more money tonight. So all the legends are coming if they can be bothered now. So,
Well, Josh, thank you very much.
Thanks very much, Eddie. Thank you. Cheers. Thank you. Cheers. Thanks.
Well done, George.
Thanks very much.